Hello, I'm Chaplain Gormley from Little Rock Air Force Base, and this is a special Rock Talk to all those that are leaders. In my hands, I have a shepherd's staff. This staff represents leadership. It represents what you've been handed in order to take care of your people. And today's challenge is to examine three areas of shepherding that are essential to the people that you are guiding. The first area to examine is your pastoral support. This is your vision and your voice. This emphasizes who you are. And I'm not talking about being a church pastor, a priest, or a religious leader. I'm not talking about the position. I'm talking about the practice. The word pastor means shepherd. Ladies and gentlemen, you are a shepherd. And that means that you are charged. Charged to provide a vision, a direction, and most of all, a voice. A voice to airmen and families under your leadership. We look to you and we rely on your voice. The second area to examine is your personable spirit. I'm not saying that you have to be some type of ultra-charming leader. I'm saying that you should evaluate your spirit of connection. Wisdom represented in my faith teaches of a great shepherd who says, "My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me." Notice that the great shepherd not just only has a voice, he also knows and connects with his sheep. The sheep are moved to follow. Each day your airmen hear teachings, comprehensive airman fitness, direction, planning, AFI. In short, we hear your voice, but we also want to hear your spirit. Be real with us. Tell us about your personal, monumental experiences that have helped shape you. Tell us what gives you hope and energy. Share with us what books impacted your philosophy. Give us a glimpse of your spirit so that we can follow not just your commands, but also your heart. The last point is to examine proximal surroundings. Proximal just means near and around the body. This highlights two things: community and workplace culture. A shepherd's staff also acts as an extension. Notice that behind each politician or CEO is a staff of people. In what ways are we involving others to share the support and guidance of the people? In what ways are we building leaders that extend your principles and philosophies to the workplace? In what ways are we allowing mental health, the chapel, and AFRC to not just inform, but to also infiltrate our units? Great leaders are conductors that orchestrate victories that can be shared by many involved. In conclusion, I hope that you are inspired to look at your leadership style through the lens of a shepherd. Because whether it is through the valleys or on the mountaintops, hope is not dependent only on where we are at. Hope is also dependent upon who we are following. This is your Rock Talk from the Chapel team at Little Rock Air Force Base. Keep rocking on.